Hey YouTube. In today's video, I will show you how you can include Docker containers and container services into NixOS configuration. So for this, we will install Podman as a direct alternative for Docker. And we will also define a Podman configuration that can be shared between different computers. So we only need to set up this once, and we can use basically the same configuration for Podman/Docker on our desktop, our laptop, and so on and so forth. So let's dive into it. As I said, I want to have the base configuration for Podman shareable between different machines, because I don't know how you roll, but for me, I usually have the same settings for Podman or Docker, no matter if I am on my laptop or on a server or any other machine, really. Therefore, we will put our Podman configuration into our host's common folder. And that's the place in the NixFlake we have configured in the last couple of videos, which will be shared between all the hosts. And we will also make something similar like the feature sets in the home configurations, so we can just enable and disable Podman dependent on the host just with one liner. What I will do at first is I will create a new subfolder in the host's common folder, and I will name this extra services. Within this folder, I will create a podman.nix file, and I will also create a default.nix file. In the default.nix file, the only thing I will really do for now is I will just import Nix, and in podman.nix we will define our service. What we also need to do is we need to go to the default.nix in the common folder, and we need to import our extra services here. And now we can start configuring our Podman service here. The bare minimum to enable Podman would be to declare virtualization.podman.enable equals true. That's enough to get the Podman service up and running, but I will configure some extra settings here that I use in my production environments. The first thing I do is I enable Docker compatibility. When this is enabled, I can just use the Docker command instead of the Podman command. That's very helpful, especially when you are reading documentations and you want to copy paste a Docker run command or anything. That's usually written for the Docker command, and that basically eliminates the need to always make changes and replace the Docker commands with Podman commands. So that helps a lot. And what I also would like to enable is the auto prune function. So we enable this here and we give it the option dates. And in the option dates, we just tell it to do this weekly. So what this basically does, it will remove all dangling containers and everything that's not used and will just clutter the system. Because when you work with containers a lot, this tends to get messy because you will have, I don't know, like 5 versions of the same container after a while. And this will basically remove anything that is not used. And by default, the prune functionality for Podman will not remove any volumes. And that's actually what we want, because usually when we have a container, we store our persistent data in a volume, and that's kind of the only part of the container thing that is not replaceable and we want to keep, of course. And I just give it 2 additional filter flags, so it will just remove stuff that is older than 24 hours and that does not have the label important. What this does actually is when I create a container on a machine, and let's say that's for testing purposes or I'm working on it, I can just give it the label important, and then the prune command will just ignore that container, and that's also very helpful. And what I also would like to set here is the DNS for the Podman network settings. And this basically enables us to refer to containers by the host name. So when I have a container stack that consists of, I don't know, typical web stack, let's say you have a WordPress and you have a MySQL and so on and so forth. And the container, then you can refer, for example, to the MySQL container just by the name, and the DNS will resolve to the IP address on the Docker network. What I also would like to do is I would like to install Podman Compose as a drop-in replacement for Docker Compose. This will enable us to run Docker Compose stacks defined in a Docker Compose file. And as you can see, it complains that packages is not available. So we bring that in here. And now I will try to update our configuration. And when I go to my virtual machine and just run the Podman command, you can see Podman and Podman Compose are available here. As I said in the start of the video, I would like to have this shareable between hosts. And the other part of making it shareable is I want to be able to easily decide if I want to include this into my configuration or not. And as you might remember, we did something on the user level where we had this features block here and where we could basically enable or disable different feature sets we have created within our configuration. The same I would like to do here. And this basically works exactly the same way as we did it on the user configuration. I will get our config, I will get lib, and then we will create an enable option on extra services for Podman. Here we need to make a little correction. What this does is it will only evaluate this block which is defining Podman and Podman Compose in case the option is enabled. And in order to have this working, I will go to our hosts folder into the default.nix file. And here I can just add an extra services.podman.enable equals true. And now we test if this is working. And you can see Podman is still available. And when we set this to false and rebuild our configuration and head back to our virtual machine, you can see Podman is not available. So I will just enable this again. And for the definition of the containers, I will do this inside of our host folder. You could, of course, do shared container configurations in the common folder in case you have containers that need to run on any machine or on multiple machines, but in my scenario here, I will just do that per host. And what I will do now is I will create a new folder under my hostname folder and call this one services. I will create a default.nix file, and I will also create a containers folder within the service folder, and this should also contain a default.nix file. Just for testing purposes, I will just install a very simple HTTP echo container. So under containers, I will just create a file echo.nix. And in the default folder for the containers directory, I will just import echo.nix. And then I will go to the default.nix file that is directly in my host folder here. And here we have the imports, and just let me make this a little bit more readable. Here we just import the services. And the configuration of Docker containers inside of a NixOS configuration is very straightforward. So you have under virtualization, OCI containers, containers. You have your container name. So you could, for example, also go like this. And then you refer to the image like you would usually do when you find a container on Docker Hub or any other container repo. So what you can do here, for example, is you could also include the colon latest or any kind of version. as we are using NixOS, we are being very precise when it comes to reproducibility. So I would suggest to put an exact version here on real containers. And here we can define extra options we would give to the Docker or Podman CLI command. And here we just define the ports for now. And that's, as I said, a very easy example for now. So I'll just save this here and add the files to our repo once more. And we got an error here, and that's because I forgot to import containers into our default.nix in our services folder. So we will try this again. And when I go back to our virtual machine and just make a sudo podman ps, you can see that the echo container is running. And the reason I needed to put a sudo command is we are doing this in the system space, not in the user space. So this is only available behind the sudo command. When it comes to Podman, you have kind of two sides on your system. So for example, when you enter sudo podman image ls, you can see under the root user here, you have the image for the container we are running now. And when I just do that on our user space, you can see there is no image available. So this is clearly separated between the admin user and each individual user. So each user can kind of have his own repository for images and so on and so forth. And when I call my server with an HTTP request on port 5678, I get the hello world back from our little echo server. A small detail I would like to talk about is the use of networks, because what you can do is you can pass a network to the defined container, and this will basically make this container part of a network. So when you have different services running that depend on each other, it makes sense to build a network with the containers that need to talk to each other. When we have added the network to our container configuration here and we try to rebuild our system, you can see we get an error while switching to the new configuration. And the problem is really that the network is not available now because we haven't defined it. And of course, you could just go to your host and execute a Podman network create and then the name of the network. But that's actually an extra step again. So a better way to do this is to include this already into our configuration here. And for that, we can make use of activation scripts in NixOS. And that's just basically a script that is appended to the activation scripts Nix is running when booting the system. So what we do here is we just check if the network exists. So when we have a look at the Podman network command, we can have a look here, and you can see we have this here. So we can use Podman to check if the network already exists, and that's what we are doing here in the script. So this is just a simple bash script. We will just check if the network exists here, and if it doesn't exist, we will just create it. And we are using the lib make after function, so we need to make lib available here. And now when we try again, we don't get an activation error here, and when we check here now, you can see that the network web has been created. And this is something you can basically do on all of your container definitions. So the way I do it is I make a Nix file for each container, because the container definitions tend to get more complicated and a little bit longer. You can define more complicated sets of containers also in Nix. Usually you will have something like environment variables and so on and so forth. For me, it's just best practice to have one Nix file per containers. And that makes it also very easy to reuse a container definition on another machine. So I can just copy it over. That's a very basic overview of how you can work with Docker containers on Nix. Nix is also able to build Docker containers that are very small and very efficient. We might look into this in a later video. Another important part we will go into in the next video is the topic secrets. Usually you have a lot of secrets to manage when you build up a system. So you have API keys, you have environment variables, you have environment files. Of course, it also makes sense to do all of this in a declarative way, because you don't want to install your whole system just with one command and then have busy work to do to get all the secrets and all the files in. So there's also a way for that, and I will show that in the next video. That's all from me today, and if you have questions, just drop a comment or send me a DM, and yeah, have a nice time. Bye-bye.